So let's finish this clustering process. So what are you thinking of doing next?
Well, DNF and BNG, we both thought were pretty close. So let's just do DNF.
Well, DNF doesn't matter much anymore because they're already in the same cluster.
Oh, that's so a good point. That's a good point.
So what is their intercluster distance?
It's zero.
Yes.
Because they're in the same cluster. That's a fine point you make there, Michael.
Sure. Thanks.
How about BNG then?
I like BNG. And what do we do next?
Well, we've got two nice clusters. So actually, if we were to merge the next cluster, we would end up with, I guess, B and D together. Doesn't really matter because it's going to merge the last two clusters together.
Yeah. So in particular, what I was getting at is we don't do any merging next because now this repeat loop is done. So this is what we end up with. Assuming that we had start off setting k equals 2, mm-hmm. then we're done at this point. We have what looks like a backwards R and a funny looking, actually, they look like Hebrew letters to me, but that's probably not a universal perspective. So just one other thing to point out quickly. So we can represent the series of merges that we did using a structure that's kind of like this. We merged A and B first, and then we merged C and D, and then we merged, I think, D and E.
Yeah.
Or the C, D, and E. And then we merged E and F. And then we merged G and the AB cluster, and then that left us with the two clusters. So this, in some sense, we've captured the same information about what's connected with what, but this is kind of a nice way of representing it because it actually gives us a hierarchical structure, a tree structure.
A kind of hierarchical agglomerative structure.
And there's lots of applications where it's actually useful to have that extra bit of information because we can now very easily look at, remember in the beginning you said that you could see three clusters? Well, you can see if you just cut this tree structure here, we get the three, oh, not quite. We almost get the three clusters that you wanted. Here it looks like F is separated from the other ones. It depends which distances we thought were closer.
And also, if you combine those two clusters again, the last two clusters, then basically you have a true tree with a single root.
That's right. And that's kind of, that summarizes all the different cluster structures that you can get out of single link clustering.
I like that. So I have a question, Michael.
Shoot.
Well, I have two questions. The first question is, do you know the difference between further and farther?
I do, though I sometimes use them interchangeably.
Yeah. It turns out, interestingly enough, that the definitions of further and farther switch every 100 years or so. And unfortunately, I was born in a time period where they're switching meanings again, and so it drives me nuts. But in any case, for our listeners, farther means physical distance, and further means metaphysical or metaphorical distance. So one lives farther down the road but goes further into debt. And you should almost never confuse the two. The people currently are using further as if it means farther. So I have a question here for you. Which is, you define the intercluster distance as the distance between the closest two points in the two clusters?
Yep, that's what it says right here.
Yeah, as if that were an immutable fact of the algorithm. Is it, or could we do something else? What would happen if we picked average distance or distance between the farthest two points as opposed to furthest two points or some other measure?
Well, we don't know if this is physical distance or metaphorical distance, right? Or metaphysical distance. It's just D.
That's true.
But so it's like, we'll call it farthest with an O.
Please don't.
The farthest points, yes. Good. An average is another one. That's true. Yeah, these are different things you could define. My recollection of this is they're no longer single-link clustering. Single-link clustering is defined to be closest. But you also have other things like average-link clustering, which I think is the one with the average. And then there's maybe max-link clustering. I forget exactly what it's called, or it does the farthest.
I think I saw a talk once that I didn't understand, which had to do with median distances, and that somehow you could prove interesting things because of it, as opposed to the mean, which is what I think you mean by average there.
Yeah, average meaning mean. Yeah, I mean generally, things like median are really good if the numbers on the distances don't matter, just their orderings.
Hmm.
So sometimes people describe that as being metric versus non-metric. Non-metric, median is usually a non-metric statistic. Average is a metric statistic. It actually, the details of the numbers matter a lot.
Okay. Well, that all makes sense. I guess the basic idea is that what I was saying before, that the distance was some notion of where your domain knowledge comes in. I guess it's also true that how you define intercluster distance is also a kind of domain knowledge. It's another parameter to the algorithm. Does that seem fair?
Yeah.
Okay.